Good morning. Today is the 19th day of June in this 2024th year of our Lord. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The weather outside, it looks pretty decent. We have some overcast sky, a nice breeze blowing. Temperatures are not as bad as they could be. So I think it's going to be a pretty nice day. Be nice if I got a shower out of that cloud cover, but I'm not so certain if we will. Today in history is noted in many a community as Juneteenth, the 19th day of June in the year 1865. The people of Louisiana and Texas finally got the word that in 1863, President Abraham Lincoln had declared an Emancipation Proclamation freeing the slaves of the South and of the nation. And apparently the folk in Texas, and not surprising, but the folk in Texas and Louisiana didn't get the message. They had held on to their slaves for those extra 2 years. Not all, of course, were emancipated across the South. But finally, word of that, and nearing the end of the war, the slaves of those two states, great states, were freed, and history took its course. So that's a celebration in the Afro-American community today. It happened and started over the weekend with parade in Georgetown and other activities. So be mindful of our past, our history, lest we repeat it. Should be remembered, that's a great day to have commemorated. Today, a reading of the 128th Psalm. Often have they attacked me from my youth. Let Israel now say, often have they attacked me from my youth, yet they have not prevailed against me. The plowers plowed on my back. They made their furrows long. The Lord is righteous. He has cut the cords of the wicked. May all who hate Zion be put to shame and turn backward. Let them be like the grass on the housetops that withers before it grows up, with which reapers do not fill their hands, or binders of sheaves their arms, while those who pass by do not say, "The blessings of the Lord be upon you. We bless you in the name of the Lord." Rather unusual passage, but nonetheless a part of the word that we hear this day. From Meditations of a Hermit by Charles de Foucauld. Our Lord asks great faith from us, and he is right. We owe him great faith. After our Lord said, "Come to him," Peter had no more fear and walked upon the waters. So that when Jesus has quite certainly called us to certain circumstances in life, given us a certain vocation, we need fear nothing, but should attack the most insurmountable obstacles without hesitation. If Jesus has said, "Come," we have the grace to walk upon the waters. It may seem to us impossible, but Jesus overmasters the impossible. So we need three things. First, to call out to our Lord very clearly. And then, when we have distinctively heard his "come," without the summons, we have not the right to throw ourselves into the water. It would be presumptuous, imprudent, and rash, and a risk of the life of the soul. It would be sinful, even to mortal sin, for to risk the life of the soul is even graver than to risk the life of the body. Once his "come" is heard by the soul, till that moment our duty is simply to pray and wait. We must hesitate no more, but throw ourselves into the water like Peter, and confident in the call that God has given, walk over the waves without hesitation, without the least doubt or fear, sure that if we go forward in faith and confidence, the path that Jesus calls us to follow, will become easy to us by the virtue of his call come. So let us walk with perfect faith in the way along which he calls us, for heaven and earth shall pass away, but his word shall not pass. And let us pray. Lord, let us be patient, but to listen intently to your calling to us in that time and in that place that we are needed the most. And let us respond as Peter did in confident faith that you would hold our hand as we go forth into the valleys of the shadow of death, into those places that we are fearful of, into those moments when we would run as Jonah ran away from your calling and place ourselves under not your care, not your love, not your direction, but our own. Yes, we are a sinful people who seek our own way and our own will more so than we seek yours. Help us to have confidence that when you call us sometimes to a cross that might bring our lives into difficult waters, but you bear us up and you have shown us the beauty of the tomorrows beyond the tribulations of this life. You have shown us the resurrection way of your Son Jesus, whom you took to your side forevermore and promised us the same. Give us confidence in your nearness to us, in the things that we say and the things that we do this day, and help us to be attentive. Bless those who struggle in life. The Lord, the peoples of Gaza, Israel, Russia, the peoples of the Ukraine, in their conflicts one with another. Bring resolve, bring an end to terrorism and threats against peoples that do not think and believe as each do. Help us to embrace the diversity of culture, of religion, of ethnicity, and help us, O Lord, to see the value and your face in each person in this world, that it might be the place you created it to be. Care for those that we would pray for this day, for Nikki and Tom and Donna, for Roger and Hunter, for Elaine, for Miriam, for Mark and Katie, for James and Evelyn, for Evelyn Tompkins, for Laura, for Kenneth and Gay, for Jenny and Linda, for Carol Miller, for Judy in her time of grief, Judy Hoffman, and for Charlotte, for Gail, and for each that we lift up to you in this moment of silence. Into your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy, your Son Jesus, who taught us that we might pray together. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine on you, to be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor, giving you his peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord this day and forevermore. Amen.